Tommy Lahren's an OutKick host, and she joins me now. So how do you run against a guy like this, Tommy?
Well, you'd think it would be fairly easy to run against a guy like that. And as much as we can laugh at Joe and his greatest hits, the joke is really on us because this is how confident Democrats are in their election strategy. Jesse, they don't have an election machine. They have an election wood chipper, and they know it. So we could very well be looking at the reelection of Joe Biden. We've also got John Fetterman, many others who were incoherent, almost vegetable-like, that are serving in high places in our government. And these people can be elected and reelected from the basement or maybe even the morgue at this point, because that's how good Democrats are at elections.
Well, it's about ballot production. It's no longer about persuasion. We know that. Right now, I'm seeing this, though, Cross, Tommy. I'm seeing a Harvard-Harris poll that has Trump up 6 points on Joe Biden. Do you believe that?
I do believe it, and I also believe that Democrats know this. And I have a theory, Jesse. I believe that they are going to let Joe Biden speak freely. I believe they are going to let him campaign because they want him to dig his own grave so that they have reason then to bring in Gavin Newsom. So I think you're going to see the downfall of Biden, and I think that you're going to see the Democrats and the mainstream media finally let it happen because they don't want to have to prop this man up anymore like Weekend at Bernie's. They're waiting for Gavin Newsom to come in, so I think they're about to pull the ripcord here, and we might see Biden being thrown under the bus.
Maybe that explains the Hannity Newsom interview. He was just getting warmed up in the bullpen. You did mention John Fetterman. As you remember, there was that enormous bridge collapse explosion in Pennsylvania outside of Philly on 95. John Fetterman represents Pennsylvania. It came up at a hearing. Here he is, Tommy.
The tragic accident in 995, and if you want to make any comments with respect to that, feel free, you're recognized.
I would really like to, you know, the 95, you know.
I feel terrible for this guy, and I feel even worse for the people of Pennsylvania. How do you feel?
Yeah, it's painful to watch, and everybody knows how painful this is to watch. And the fact that these people are still serving, Dianne Feinstein being another one, I mean, this isn't fair to the people they're representing. These people are likely going to vote for a Democrat, but my goodness, could you at least give us a Democrat who can put together a complete sentence and maybe even lie with some coherence like some of the other Democrats do? I mean, we got Obama, lies, but lies coherently. We got Hillary Clinton, lies, but lies coherently. Is that really too much to ask for, your Democrats to lie to you in a complete sentence?
We'd rather have a liar than someone that can't even talk. All right, Tommy Lahren, have a great weekend. I'll see you out there at Dodger Stadium, maybe, at the protest. We'll be covering that next.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.
Well, they had it online. I mean, maybe they didn't put it in the paper, but so Biden's got the 7-point lead over Trump, according to the New York Post. The New York poll showed, and
like here, Joe.
Biden's, there it is. Biden's crushing, absolutely crushing Donald Trump in this poll. Now, do I think that this is the end-all, be-all poll? I mean, it's in the New York Post, so of course I do. But other than that, are we going to talk about this poll now for a month, like we talked about the one bad Joe Biden poll? We showed you a poll the other day that was from The Economist, one of the most respected publications on the planet. They had Joe Biden at 50%. Do I think he's at 50%? Probably not. Maybe it's an outlier, but guess what? I didn't hear the media talk about that for a week and a half. I didn't have, like, Democrats telling me they had to tear the sheets from their bed because they wet their bed for a week talking about how badly Joe Biden was going to do next year. It's all very selective. I swear to God, it's the one poll, the one poll. And people are still writing articles, like in major newspapers, saying, well, you know, Joe Biden, you know, he has a 36% approval rating, and the world's coming to an end. Well, New York Post, paper of record, what do they have him at? They have him crushing Donald Trump, 47-40. The Economist has him at 50% among registered voters. Let's talk about these for a week. Seriously, let's talk about these for a week. If we're talking outliers, it's just stupid.
Tommy Lahren's an OutKick host, And she joins me now. So how do you run against a guy like this, Tommy?
Well, you'd think it would be fairly easy to run against a guy like that. And as much as we can laugh at Joe and his greatest hits, the joke is really on us because this is how confident Democrats are in their election strategy. Jesse, they don't have an election machine.